Hello friends, this is Shravan. This is my YouTube channel Civil Engineering by Shravan. To subscribe my channel, click on subscribe button and click on bell icon for more interesting updates. In this video, I will explain you analysis and designing of steel warehouse by using StatPro VITI software. So initially, I will show you the model for that respected small warehouse. So select this image. So this is the model. So initially, I will model this respected warehouse by using StatPro software. So after that, I will design this respected warehouse. So initially, I will take the center to center distance between the columns in the front view is 6 meter. Again, I will take the center to center distance between the respected side view is 4 meter. Okay, so initially go to click on StatPro software. Click on StatPro software here. So click on new project here. Click on spacing option. Give the file name. Just I am taking it as double. Save your file location as per your respected requirements. So here I am selecting length units will be in meter as well as force units will be in kilonewton. Click on next button. Click on finish button. Now the software will be open like this. So it will be consisting of 10 number of grids in x direction as well as 10 number of grids in y direction. So initially I will start this respected warehouse modeling from this respected grids. So initially I am selecting 0, 0 here. So select respected distance as 4 meter. Just I am assuming is. So click on this respected 3 meter. So here I am taking this respected 6 meter. Again come to the first point. Okay. So this is the center to center distance between the front facing is 6 meter here. Okay. So after that click on hide snap node beam. So this is the frame. So we need to copy this respected frame in z direction distance. So for that select all these respected frames by using Ctrl A option. Go to transitional repeat, which is in z direction. So here we have to assume this respected spacing options. So as per this respected figure, we are assumed that number of columns in this respected z direction are 4. So it was created with one column here. So we had to copy remaining 3 columns. So for that initially we have to take the number of steps are 3 and each step will be consisting of 4 meter. Click on link steps option, click on OK. So now we can see the warehouse model was created here like this. So after that select the front view option, select all the beam sections at the base. So click on delete option, click on S button. So after that we had to add the bracings for this respected warehouse. So for that select add beam command here, select the first point, select the second point, select the first point, select the second point. In the same way we had to add the bracings for the respected whole model. So here I am rotating the model here. Again we have to add the bracings for the right hand side also. So after that click on 3D model. So after adding the bracing sections, we have to add the members which is supported on the top of the roof. So for that initially we have to select the top view. So we have to select all the beam sections here. So here I am selecting all the beams like this. So click on insert node. So here I am taking number of nodes will be consisting of 3 points. Click on OK. So it will insert this respected node points here like this. So after that click on this respected 3D model. So it was created your respected node point with equal distance. Okay. So after that select top view. So here we have to select the node cursor. Just I am selecting the nodes for this respected right hand side section. Again I am selecting the nodes for this respected left hand side section. So click on 3D view. So we have to connect this respected node points with the help of the beams. So go to geometry, connect beams along z-axis. So it will create 18 number of the beams for this respected warehouse section like this. Now we have to see this respected whole model in rendering view. So click on rendering view option. So this is the rendering view for this respected lines, nothing but your grids for this respected warehouse. So after modeling process completed, we have to assign the beam sizes and column sizes and this respected member sizes for this respected warehouse. So for that initially we had to create the steel structure models from the database. So for that select general option here, click on section database. So it will open this respected section database values like this. So in this we had to select as per the Indian standard system. Just I am selecting. So here I am selecting double section. So we had to select any one of the section from this respected model. So here I am considering 350 by 300 by 10 model one. So again I will take 350 by 300 by 12 model another one. Okay. So after that I will add angle section. So which is consisting of, let us assume 100 by 100 by 15. Click on add button, close option. So here we have to select this respected 350 cross 300 cross 10. We have to assign this respected property for the horizontal members. So here I'm selecting horizontal beam sections for this respected warehouse like this. So after that, select this respected vertical members also. Now here we have to select the right hand side members also for this respected model. So here I'm selecting these models. So after that, click on assign to selected beams, assign yes option. Again we have to select R2, just I will assign this respected R2 for the column sections. Go to select option, beams parallel to y axis, click on assign to selected beams, assign yes option. So after that we have to assign this respected ISA 100 by 100 by 15 for the remaining models. So go to select by missing attribute, missing property, click on assign to selected beams here, assign yes option. After assigning the properties, we need to see this respected whole model in rendering view. So click on 3D view, click on this respected modeling option, click on rendering view. So this is the rendering view for this respected warehouse. It will be consisting of 350 cross 300 cross 12 is the column size, and 350 cross 300 cross 10 is the beam sizes, and the remaining sections I was considered it as angle section, which is consisting of 100 by 100 by 15. Okay, so this is the rendering view for this respected warehouse. So after that we have to assign the supports for this respected warehouse. So click on general option, select the supports, select the front view. So initially we will create the fixed supports, create option, click on add, select the support to, select the node points, all the node points, click on assign to selected nodes, assign yes. So after that we had to define the load cases, which is related to the respected seismic loading condition, so as well as wind loading condition. But as per IS 875 part 3, it was suggested that if the structure or any one of the building which is greater than your 10 meter, we need to apply the wind loading case, otherwise we can skip the wind loading conditions. So for this respected warehouse, I was considered it as height as 6 meter, so that's why I'm eliminating the wind loading conditions. Okay, so for that initially we have to define the seismic loading condition, select definition option, select the seismic definitions, click on add button. So here we have to select the IS code, IS 1893, click on generate option. So here I'm selecting the zone which is consisting of zone 4, which is having the factor of 0.24 condition, and we have to select this respected or special RC movement resisting frame. So after that we have to select the important factor for all general buildings, and we have to consider the structure type is steel frame building with a soil medium condition. So here I'm taking damping ratio is 0.05. click on generate option. So it will generate the parameters here. So after that click on add button. So now we have to add the self weight as one, add option, close option. So after that we have to define the load case details. So select load case details option, click on add button. So initially we had to add the seismic loading condition. So here I'm defining the earthquake load, which is in x direction condition. Again I'm selecting the earthquake load, which is z direction condition, add button. So after that we had to add the dead loading condition, DL, add button. Again we had to add the live loading condition, LL, add it. So after that click on close option. Now we have to select the earthquake load, which is in x direction condition. We have to apply the forces which is related to the x direction only. So click on add button. So here we have to select the seismic load, which is in x direction with a factor as 1. Add it, close option. Select earthquake load z, add button. In the same way we have to select the seismic load, which is in z direction with the factor 1. Add button, close option. Now we have to select the self weight for the dead loading condition. Click on add button, close option, select the self weight, assign to view, assign yes option. So after that we have to select the live loading condition. So for this respected structure we have to apply the live load for the respected nodes. We have to apply the nodal load for this respected node cases. Okay, so click on add button. So here I'm selecting the nodal load, which is having intensity of -20, just I'm assuming kilonewton, which is acting for the all the node cases. Click on add button, close option. Select the FY, assign to view option, assign yes. So after that we had to apply the load combinations. So select load case details, add button. So here we had to select the auto load combination generation as per the seismic load, dead load, live load. Select the load case code as Indian, click on generate load combination, add button, close option. So after that we had to select the materials, select the steel material, assign to view, assign yes. So after that, we have to analyze this respected model. Go to analysis and print, add your no print option, close option. Go to analyze option, run analysis, save it. So here we have to check the zero errors for this respected model. So here my model is checking for the zero errors. It was observed with zero errors here. Go to post processing mode option, click on done option, click on apply, click on OK. So this is the deflection diagram for this respected model. Due to presence of the live loading condition, it was deflecting downward direction. Why? Because we are applied the gravity load, which is in downward direction. So after that, select the earthquake load in x direction condition. Due to presence of the seismic zone 4, the building is deflecting in this respected x direction condition like this. Okay, now you can see the deflection diagram here like this. So after that, select the side view, apply the load case as y direction load case. So this is the deflection due to presence of the seismic loading condition, which is in y direction. So after that, we have to select this respected 3D view. So now we have to select the dead load condition or live load condition. This is the live load condition deflection diagram, and this is the dead load condition deflection diagram. So after that, we have to check the shear force diagram as well as bending moment diagram. So for that, select the beam here, deselect the MZ, select FI. So this is the shear force diagram for this respective structure. So after that, select MZ value. So this is the bending moment diagram for this respective structure. Okay. So after that, we have to select the animation, apply your deflection, apply OK. So this is the deflection diagram due to presence of dead load, due to presence of live load, again due to presence of earthquake load x direction, earthquake load in z direction. So after analysis process completed, we have to design this respective steel structure by using IS 800 code. So for that, go to select the modeling option, click on design option. So here we have to select the steel design. So here we have to select the code as per IS 800 LSD section. So it will be consisting of IS 800 LSD 2007 here. Select this, click on select the parameters. So here initially we have to deselect all parameters. From these parameters, we need to pick only two parameters which are related to the tracking parameter as well as yield strength of the steel. So select the track parameter initially. So after that, we have to select the yield strength of the steel. So here I'm selecting yield strength of the steel. Click on OK. So after that, click on define parameters. Initially, we have to define the yield strength value. So here I'm assuming 500 Fe 500 grade steel for this respected steel members. Click on add. So after that, click on track parameter. It will be consisting of three values here, 0, 1, 2. 0 is nothing but print the design output at the minimum detail level. 1 is nothing but print the design output at intermediate level. So second one is nothing but print the design output at maximum designing level. Okay. So it will, so from this respected parameter, just I'm selecting as 2. Why? Because we need to have the design data as per the maximum parameter level. So click on add button, close option, select the comments option. So initially we have to select the check code option. So after that, select the member takeoff. So after that, select the select option, add button, select the takeoff option, add button, close option. So after that, we have to select the FY yield strength by using assign to view, assign yes option. Select track by using assign to view, assign yes option. Select the check code by using assign to view, assign yes option. So select the steel member takeoff, assign to view, assign yes option. So after that, we have to select the select option here again. Click on assign to view, assign yes. Again, you have to select the steel takeoff, click on assign to view, assign yes. So after that, go to analysis and print again, add your no print again, close option again. Go to analyze again, run analysis again, click on save option again. So again, we have to check for the zero errors for this respected model also. So here my model is checking for the zero errors. So here my model is observed with zero errors. Go to post processing mode again, click on done option again. Again, select the beam, deselect the bending moment diagram, select any one of the column, double click on it. So this is the steel design results, which is consisting of W 350 x 300 x 10 mm section. So it is sufficient. As per the definitions, we are assumed that as per the safety, W 350 x 300 x 12 section. But as per the design results, as per the your consideration, it is showing that the steel which is consisting of 350 x 300 x 10 is the sufficient for designing of this respected warehouse. Again, I will select one more beam section, double click on it, click on steel design. So it will be consisting of same steel design results, which is of 350 x 300 x 10. So this is the design property data, deflection, shear bending, loading. So after that, we have to see the output file for this respected design. Click on Standard Output File option here. So click on Results option here. So click on Steel Design. So it will be consisting of each and individual calculation sheet for the respective steel members for this respected warehouse. Okay. So after that, we have to design the foundation for this respected warehouse. So select the foundation. So here we have to select the load cases which is related to earthquake load as well as dead load. Include. Click on Run Standard Foundation. The fixed supports of this respected warehouse will be directly imported to the Standard Foundation software. So these are the fixed supports. We need to design the foundation for this respected fixed supports. Before that, we have to apply the load combinations. So select the loads and factors. So click on generate load combinations. So select the Indian standard system. Click on generate load combinations as per the service load combinations. Again, click on generate load combinations as per the ultimate load combination. Click on OK. Now click on job setup, create job. So here I'm selecting name as steel. So select your isolated job type, isolated footing. So here I'm selecting Indian and the units will be in SI system. Again, you have to select the generated load combinations, which is related to your respected 101, 102, 201, 202, 203, 204. Include. Click on create job. So it will design this respected isolated footing on the left hand side section here like this. So here we have to select the design parameter values. If you have inputs for these respected parameters, you can give the inputs. Otherwise, you can select the standard values here. Okay, so select the cover and sail type, footing geometry, sliding and overturning. Click on design option. Click on S button. So it is test designing of isolated footing as per IS 456-2000 code. So this is the isolated footing design as per IS 456-2000. So here I am selecting isolated footing 15. So this is the isolated footing 15 design as per IS 456-2000 code. So this is the starting page, geometry, details and drawing, GA drawing, calculation sheet. So this is the process, analysis and designing of industrial warehouse by using STAT Pro VATI software. So if you have any queries about this respected industrial warehouse design, please text me your questions in the below comment box. I will give you the answer for that respected questions. Thank you. See you in the next one.